Thanks, Murray. Yes, and talking about who we were going to go for, I walked into the dressing room with the boys yesterday and said, boys, I really don't know who to go through. I'm a mad keen Aussie supporter of any sport, but my heart was going for the Solomons yesterday, hey? And it's a one-all draw, so there you go. They played very well. We're just going to show a video, and the reason I wanted to give a short intro is this is a video that goes way back, and there'll be people with us today who maybe wondered how we started a journey with the far-flung Solomon Islands. So we're going to go back, and it's interesting there'll be people sitting here that it'll be informative for. For some of the, you know, the youngest member of the Solomon team wasn't even born when this video was recorded. And there are two that were running around in their nappies, I'm sure. Little Samuel Arlo and Owen would have been in diapers when this one was recorded. So thanks, Fraser. Let's watch this together.
Hello, my name is Ele Tragamo.
And I'm Jack Whitney. We're both from the Solomon Islands. Today, we'd like to take you through a journey to tell you about our country and the difference which has happened in our country.
And the help
which you have provided through Juro Sports and Leisure Centre.
And I'd like to say thank you to all of the supporters and at Juro Sports and Leisure Centre, and hope you enjoy our stories.
The Solomon Islands are a group of more than 900 islands and 100 languages.
It is a nation of rolling hills, tropical climate, and beautiful God-loving people.
For years, our nation was torn apart by civil war fought with strong racial tensions between different island communities. Warlords fought against warlords and people rose in rebellion against the state.
Although today the fighting has stopped, there is still a great deal of corruption in our country and many people are still recovering from the destruction of the civil war.
For our nation to continue its recovery, our nation is blessed to continue to receive support from others. We are thankful that others have come to our need, like Ramsey Force and Juro Sports and Leisure Centre. In year 2001, Juro Sports and Leisure Centre visited the Solomon Islands for the first time, bringing a team of 8 people to introduce the sport of futsal to the Solomon Islands.
But they did not only come to spread futsal, but also hope that the word of God brings to his children. Even among such poverty, the Solomon Islands is a Christian country with 96% of population believe in God.
By visiting many schools and local communities, Juro Sports and Leisure Centre has helped to build better communities in the Solomon Islands, helping to reduce racial tension, helping to rebuild broken families, and helping to spread the word and promise of God. Futsal is not just a sport in the Solomons. Futsal has become a platform to achieve better community in the Solomon Islands.
Today, over 2,000 children in Honiara playing futsal, but there is only one indoor court in Honiara, so you will see many kids playing in the grass and dirt, whatever they can find some space to play.
When I am down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
futsal has spread throughout the province and islands, and the joy and hope which futsal has brought to us is spreading all over Solomon Islands.
Futsal is a pastime to bring so much joy to children over all Solomon Islands every day. Children are playing futsal after school, smiling.
You can see the changes that the introduction of futsal has made to the community. Futsal has renewed the faith of people in God and His plan, and through Juro Sports and Lessons Center has helped to make a difference physically, emotionally, relationally and spiritually.
I hope that all of you here today will recognize how much you have helped our nation and our people.
You raise me up so I can stand on my...
Each year, Juro Sports and Leisure Centre assists with the travel for one team from the Solomon Islands to come to Australia and to compete at the National Futsal Championship.
This year, the 14 boys Solomon Island team come to Australia and to play at the National Championship on the Gold Coast.
When the night is and the land is dark, and the moon is the only light we'll see.
The team won the final, but more importantly, this was the chance for the 10 boys from the Solomon Islands to see Australia, and for Australians to see firsthand the people of the Solomon Islands.
Just as long as you stand, stand by me.
This year, Elliot and I have been fortunate enough to be at the first participation in a new program. We are here in Australia only, an exchange program, and we have been in Australia since September 2005.
We stay with host family from Juro Baptist Church, and we go to school at William Clark College in Kellyville. We are here in Australia to learn about Australian life, to participate in school environment, and of course to play futsal.
It has been a wonderful year so far, and we have learned a lot.
We will be going home in July, but before we go back to the Solomons, we would like to thank everyone who has been our friend here in Australia. We have learned so much from you, and we have really enjoyed being your friend.
Stand by me, won't you stand by me?
Stand by me.
This has been the story of us and of our nation.
For the Solomon Islands, the road to recovery has only just begun. But with the support of many people who are doing God's work, I'm sure that, as our national anthem says, our nation, Solomon Islands, will stand forevermore.
I would like to thank you, everyone at Juro Sport and Leisure Centre and Juro Baptist Church, on behalf of all the people of the Solomon Island, for introducing futsal to our country and for continuing to help us to rebuild our nation.
Thank you, our friends from Juro Sport.
Thank you very much. Look at you, fella.
Well, let's give them a round of applause as the boys come up. Would you come up, boys? We'll get the whole team up on the stage now. How are you? Hey, come across. Come right across. Yeah, Francis, I'll get you out here. Well, it's a wonderful privilege to have our team with us. Elliot, you haven't changed a bit from that video. Hey? What's your secret to eternal youth? That's great. Just want to introduce Damon. Damon Shaw is the new coach of the Solomon Islands. And yesterday was the first time that the Solomons managed to get close to Australia. It was a one-all draw. So it'll be a fantastic game tomorrow night. Come along and enjoy. So congratulations, Damon. Wonderful. And the boys, of course, but you working with them. And it's some of the things when on that video where it said there's no full-size court in the Solomons, we are blessed. I was blown away on this visit last week to find that there are now 4 and soon to be 5 international-size futsal courts in the main city of Honiara, which will mean that these boys will continue to grow. And it's also a wonderful place for us to be continuing to do our development and to sow into the lives of the young Solomon Islanders. Elliot, I'm just going to give a microphone to you. Why don't you take this one? What's it like for you to be back in at Dural in Australia?
First of all, I think just watching that video, it gives me a lot of goosebumps. Yeah, I cried just sitting down there. I'm so, I think I'm so blessed and thankful for what this church and what you have done for us. It's a journey where, like, it's always a journey where we faced a lot of challenges here, but I think we are so thankful that God is working in so many ways here, and so many beautiful ways that it can bring people together. And I remember I remember being around here as a little kid, yeah, and this place has so many memories, yeah, and to see the love and the heart of people of Dural, and especially what God has blessed you with, to actually invested so much of your time and also your prayers for Solomon's is incredible. And I think for me to come back here, Brian, is I call this place my home, and I grew up here, and I have so many friends here, I have so many families here, and I have so many people that I call family, and I am so grateful and so thankful to come back here, and especially to be around an environment where I know there are so many loving people, and God is working in so many ways here.
Thanks, Elliot. Thank you. Yeah, it's an emotional time for all of us to see you back here. Francis, we might give this to Francis. Francis, your journey is a little bit different. You're now no longer a player in the team. You are now part of the coaching staff. Tell us what that transition for you has been like.
Hello, everyone. Yeah, it's good to be back home again. Yeah. Thank you, Brian, for inviting us this morning. I'm so blessed to stand in front of you guys. As Brian already said, I used to be a player, yeah. 13 years old running at Dural in 2004, yeah, 2004. And in 2008, FACE World Cup, we qualified. In 2008, and we go and play in Brazil. We came back from that World Cup, and in 2012, I'm out from the squad, yeah? I'm out from the squad in 2012, and for me, life is end, yeah? It looked like there's no future for me. The time when I was left out from the squad. But I remember one day we met with you, Brian, at Mendon Hotel, yeah? And we are having a lunch, and we talk, and I talk to you, I say, my life is end, yeah? And then you come up with a program, Salt Ministry, yeah? Salt Ministry. You send up 7 of us, yeah, go to Fiji for the sport ministry, and from 1 month in Fiji, and we came here in Dural for 2 months. 2 months, and we learned English. I can still see someone who teaches, Susan Deesu, and Well, yeah, Susan and Kate, yeah. In 2013 also Rob for Australianizing Futsal and also a leadership course, yeah. So from there, it brings hopes in my life, yeah. It brings my life. And you spend 2 months here, yeah. So I went back to Solomon Island. I started to work in a community to start to develop one futsal club in my community. Five of us here in this squad now. Yes, 5 of us in this squad, and I started develop my futsal coaching there. Yeah, and also we start one of the ministry from Durola Salt Ministry. Yeah, that's where place where I learn a lot from my coaching career. Yeah, so in 2016. I went back into the squad, Kurukuru, yeah. Then I represented Kurukuru again in Colombia in 2016 in Colombia World Cup, Futsal World Cup, yeah. Then from there, in 2017, we're ready to go to Turkmenistan. Then we only have one coach, Jerry Sham. Then Jerry Sham come to talk with me, how? You have to make your decision, yeah. You still play or you come and assist me? Then right at the spot, I say, okay, I want to become assistant coach. Yeah, assistant coach. So I assist Jerry Sam to the trip to Turkmenistan, yeah? It's a challenging thing. It's a challenging to, sometimes I go with the boys, but I still want to play, yeah? Because I'm still young and...
not as young as you used to be.
So that's my journey, yeah. So from 2017, 2019, we attend the World Cup in Colombia, in Lithuania, yeah. I'm there now. I'm still working with Coach Diamond, yeah. But I would like to thank Durol Baptist Church and Pastor Brian, yeah. Without you guys, Pastor Brent and the Durol Church, the boys will not stand here this morning, yeah? This is the fruit that you planted in Solomon Island, yeah? And it's still growing, and even in Solomon Island now, Salt Ministry, more than 300 kids, yeah? Inside the School of Excellence, yeah? And we are so blessed to journey with you guys, yeah? Pastor Brian and Durol Baptist Church. So for me, it's a blessing to bike again here in Durol.
Thank you, Francis.
Thank you.
Thank you. Francis, your journey is just what each player is going to go through, and that's why part of what we are wanting to do in our Salt Ministry and indeed in preparing players for life is to recognise that our identity is not in our futsal, it's not in anything except in Jesus. And I know that's where you're coming from, and you're going to bless us with some songs about that right now. So listen, I might get you to come a little bit closer to the microphone. Hello, our sound man Brendan is going to come down and save me from making a fool of myself. Thanks, Brendan. Whoop. I'm breaking a microphone. Come a little bit closer, boys, so we can get you in some...